Good evening. Roads are underwater, cars swamped, houses and businesses flooded as Sydney is smashed by rolling storm fronts. More than 100 millimetres of rain was dumped in some suburbs, and we're being warned conditions won't ease for days.
When the rain came, it came fast. And it was heavy. We'd been told to expect a storm, but the amount of water took many by surprise.
I'm here in Parramatta and the river is flooding. Just look at this.
80 millimetres fell in Wyong in just 40 minutes, 140 mils across the central coast over 3 hours. The inner west and northwest were also smashed.
Our whole backyard is flooded.
Homes were too in Rose Hill.
Down here, there, everywhere.
I was, you know, knee deep in it, pretty much where we're standing now.
This is Kirsten Burnham's house in Arcadia. The entire place was inundated.
We came home to water about just under our knees, flooding through the laundry, through the house, throughout every bedroom from start to finish.
She only moved in with her partner and 5 kids 2 weeks ago. This is just one of dozens of homes which have flooded in the area. Families who have lost almost everything now forced to find somewhere else to spend the night.
I think we're at the point where deliriously you laugh or cry. I think I laughed, Jules cried. Yeah.
Shop owners at Warringah Mall weren't laughing when it flooded. Some shops forced to close as the mop-up began. Right across Sydney, SES volunteers were run off their feet, responding to more than 570 calls for help, including 20 flood rescues. The deluge leaving many drivers stranded, they managed to get out of the water. Their cars did not.
SES units across the state are always there to serve their communities. It's been a very busy 24 hours and we're planning for another busy 24 hours.
And people weren't the only ones in need of rescue today.
Jake, we've got a gator stuck between the fences.
The rising water giving this alligator at the Australian Reptile Park the chance to make what could have been a snappy escape. But like so many, it wasn't his lucky day.
And live now to Isabel Mullen at Parramatta Weir, and the river's raging behind you there, Isabel.
Good evening, Mark. The river, Weir and Wharf are all swamped here in Parramatta, and the sound really is deafening. You can see just how quickly the water is flowing down the river. There is a large amount of debris being pushed downstream as well, and a number of tree branches which have been caught in the Weir itself. At Parramatta Wharf, it's obviously off limits to commuters. Buses will replace ferries. The rain, you might be able to see, has eased off a little. It will stop later tonight, but we can expect more this coming week. Mark.
Okay, Isabel, thank you. That torrential rain caused plenty of chaos for commuters. Trains and planes were stuck, waiting for the storms to pass, while others risked being washed away to make it home in time.
It didn't matter where in Sydney you were going today, there was no chance of staying dry. And getting anywhere treacherous in driving rain.
We've got tropical humidity that's combining with an upper-level trough and a surface trough, and that's creating particularly unstable conditions.
It was bad enough getting to the airport.
Wow, it's getting deep.
Planes had little chance. Some flights diverted to Canberra, playing a waiting game on the tarmac. Also waiting, an already strained rail network.
We are just waiting here until it is safe to proceed.
Roads across Sydney swallowed up cars, Tempe turning into a lake. Some people still risking it in a desperate bid to make it home.
Yeah, she's a little deep.
Even on foot, conditions were challenging. Coming to help this man who slipped in the floodwaters, his rescuer almost disappears down a dislodged manhole. Sydney soaked. It's been 24 hours now since the rain started coming down. The sheer volume shocking some, but not deterring others.
I've never seen a storm of this calibre. I've never seen anything like this before in my life. It's crazy.
And a warning to expect more of the same over the coming days.
It looks like these unstable conditions are going to persist well into early next week.
And Serena Andaloro is in Wallow Creek for us. Serena, it was one of the worst hit areas. How's it looking there now?
Well, the rain's eased off, the water's subsided, Mark, but as you can see, cars and roads were swamped. Take a look at this Mercedes. It was actually picked up by floodwaters, pushed onto the curb. And to add to all this, it's council clean-up day. So piles of rubbish were thrown around by floodwaters, picked up, pushed down the street. At one point, it was floating everywhere. Some parts saw more than a metre of water after rain fell too fast, and despite repeated warnings from authorities, drivers are still powering through floodwaters. It's not going to end well, Mark.
No, a big clean-up ahead. Serena, thank you. Let's go to Evan Batten now. He's at Parramatta for us this evening. Evan, the site where the next powerhouse museum will be built has also been flooded.
Yeah, good evening, Mark. Just a little way up the river from where my colleague Isabel is. And take a look at this. It's quite telling. This is the Parramatta River now level with the building site for the Powerhouse Museum. Very comfortable place for ducks and fertile ground for critics of the decision to build the Powerhouse Museum here. It has been labelled an international embarrassment. And certainly this afternoon we heard from many critics, chief among them the state Labor MP Julia Finn, who says... This is just a poor decision to decide to put the Powerhouse Museum here, and questioning who would have made such a call. It will certainly, as floodwaters continue to rise in the coming days and we see this sort of thing continue going forward, it will present quite the conundrum for any curator of the Powerhouse Museum. Mark.
Evan Batten at Parramatta. Thank you. Now, with the very latest, Angie Asimus is here. Ange, what's the situation now?
Well, Mark, we're going to continue to see severe storms. This shows the warning areas earlier. One pocket that covers the metro region, the Hunter, the Illawarra and Central Tablelands, has just been lifted, while another still spans the central west. The radar image from today shows those cells just hugged the coastline for hours. These storms were very slow moving and they just kept forming. That led to in excess of 100 millimetres in parts of Sydney and the central coast. This is why a trough over western New South Wales combining with a humid air mass and a coastal trough doing the same in the east. This is in no way letting up. Here we have the rainfall outlook for the next 7 days. By week's end, these areas in light blue show falls up to 100 millimetres. I'll have an update on the situation later, Mark.